Inshallah ta'ala, in this video, I would like to very swiftly touch on 10 common mistakes made whilst reading Suratul Fatiha. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Suratul Fatiha is considered a very important and from the opening integrals of a salah of prayer. We read it regularly on a daily basis in every single prayer. And this integral, you have to bear in mind that if one were to make a mistake whilst reading it, and if the mistake were to lead to the meaning being distorted, that would render the Suratul Fatiha as invalid, and in turn would render the entire salah, the entire prayer, as being invalid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our prayers. We put in a lot of effort to pray, and we hope and we pray that our prayers be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for that, we must ensure that we fulfill the rites of prayer, the rites of reading Suratul Fatiha. And that's why it is important for us as believers to work on improving our recitation of the noble Quran, starting off with Suratul Fatiha. So inshallah ta'ala, in this video, I would like to very swiftly touch on 10 common mistakes made whilst reading Suratul Fatiha. Common mistake number one. In the ayah, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, people tend to read it as Bismillahir Rahmanur Rahim, which is a mistake. There is a kasra under the noon, and the right way to read it, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and not Bismillahir Rahmanur Rahim. Mistake number two, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. In that ayah, people tend to read it at times as Alhamd Lillahi Rabbil Alameen, as in they go on to put a sukoon on top of the dal in Alhamd, whilst there's no sukoon there. It's actually a dhamma where you make the do sound. So the right way to read it, Alhamdu Lillahi Rabbil Alameen. The wrong way that some people tend to read it, Alhamd Lillahi Rabbil Alameen, which needs to be corrected. Mistake number three now. Maliki Yawmiddin. Some people tend to read it again with a sukoon. Malik Yawmiddin. You know, so much to the extent that at times even they are not able to notice it. Malik Yawmiddin. It almost sounds as if they're reading it the right way, but then if you observe carefully and very, you know, in a vigilant way, you will observe that they're making a subtle sukoon where they would read Malik Yawmiddin. So the right way to read it, Maliki Yawmiddin. And some people also tend to drag the word Maliki unnecessarily, where they would say Maliki Yawmiddin, which is also not right. The right way to read it, Maliki Yawmiddin. Mistake number four. And now this is an important ayah, and we tend to notice a lot of people making this mistake. The ayah that needs to be read as Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka. You know the word Iyyaka, there's a shadda, so there's this layer of emphasis, Iyyaka, Iyyaka. But people tend to read it very loosely. They read it as Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in, which entirely distorts the meaning. It changes the meaning from the right meaning, which is Ya Allah, you alone we worship and you alone we seek help. It changes it from that to, O sunlight, we worship you. O sunlight, we seek help from you. So this is something very serious, and we need to work on correcting this mistake for those who are making this mistake. Moving on to common mistake number five. If you take the ayah, Ihdina siratal, people tend to make a mistake where they read it as Ihdina siratal. So saratal, that's wrong. The right way to read it is with a kasra over the letter sad. Ihdina siratal. And then the ra too, some people tend to read it as ihdina sira, flat mouth, whilst it needs to be read round mouth. Ihdina siratal, ihdina siratal. Common mistake number six in the ayah, alladhina, people tend to read it with a Z sound, Allazina, Z, whilst the right way to read it, because the letter there is the letter Dhal, you need to read it Allazina, Allazina. And another mistake that people tend to make is with the word Allazina and an'amta, they tend to join the two words unnecessarily when reading, and they read it like reading one word. Alladhina an'amta, alladhina an'amta. The right way to read it, alladhina an'amta. So basically, alladhina an'amta alayhim, alladhina an'amta. First hamza and then ayn. The next mistake, the next common mistake that people tend to make is with the word al-maghdubi. So ghayri al-maghdubi. They tend to confuse the letter ghayn with the letter ayn. So they tend to read it ghayri al-maghdubi, which is wrong. The right way to read it, ghayri al-maghdubi, ghayri al-maghdubi. And then the word dubi, al-maghdubi, the part dubi, they tend to read it as lubi at times, or dubi with a dal or a lam, whilst the right way to read it is with the letter dad. So ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim. And the last mistake towards the end of the surah that people tend to make is with the word walad. So there, at times it is read as walad with a dal, or walat with a ta. The right way to read it, because it's a dad, walad, waladdallin. So ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim waladdallin. So as you can see, there are common mistakes that we tend to make when reading Surah Al-Fatiha. And given that Surah Al-Fatiha is an integral, it is upon us, it's a work in progress, and it is upon us to improve our recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.